Where have you been? I looked everywhere for you. My brother also vanished. Then he came back and started pacing like a lion in a cage. I was really worried. You haven't decided yet.
Yes, I've decided.
She dances wonderfully.
Beautiful, don't you think?
Well, she should. I had that dress picked out for my personal collection.
Mohammed, may I?
Of course.
Good. Over there, that gentleman standing near the punch bowl. He's General Zahidi. Very loyal to my brother. He's very audacious. He's won many battles. In the bedroom, that is. Ah, over there, that's the court minister. A true politician. Who always knows how to resolve internal political problems. Ah, he's speaking with Ayatollah Kashani, one of the most powerful religious figures in Iran. The English killed his father.
So he hates the English?
Well, no. It's the English who hate him. Look, there's Faraj. She'll keep his ear all night. Well then, come with me.
Your Majesty.
Good evening.
Thank you.
Am I important enough to merit an introduction?
Ah, Miss Soraya Esfandari Bakhtiari, Dr. Mohammed Mossadegh, Chief of the National Iranian Front and President of the Petroleum Commission.
Oh, I'm nothing but a frail old man.
Appearances can be deceiving. Mr. Mossadegh is the most important man in this country.
More important than the Shah?
Good question. I see that the throne of Peon will not only be enriched by your beauty, but also by your intelligence. Ah, Your Majesty, I've just been introduced to your fiancée. I'm astounded.
Are you always so mutually adulating?
Of course, but I'm the only one who tells the truth.
The Ayatollah Kashani has been asked to set a date.
For the Great Unification, I've consulted the mullahs. December 27th is the date of the Holy Quran.
That's the perfect day to marry my father.
Your father?
Yes. Yes, your future husband gave me life. Therefore, I consider him my father.
My father, Reza Shah, may he rest in peace, forced me to make a decision in order to get me used to governing. Dr. Mossadegh at that time was in prison.
I always find myself in prison.
Why?
Oh, because I'm a pain in the neck. It's my second career, wouldn't you say?
Well, I had to decide whether to pardon this annoying man or leave him to die in a cell. I was 18, exactly your age. I took pity on him and had him freed. When I asked my father if I had made the right decision, he said I was the only one who knew the answer.
So then?
One day I'll let you know. Ho, ho! Oh.
My father would always bring me here when I was little.
To show you how the Pahlavis treated the Bakhtiaris.
Isn't that the reason that you're about to marry me? To repair.
It's the reason why I'm marrying Bakhtiari. It's not the reason why I'm marrying this particular Bakhtiari.
So why marry this particular Bakhtiari? We feel good together. Mohammed is really, really charming.
What did I tell you?
Isn't that the art of being the Shah? To be fascinating?
Excuse me. Dr. Ayeda has come from the palace to see Soraya.
I know Dr. Ayeda, the court doctor.
He probably came to tell you about the Shah's illness.
Enough, Bijem. Leave the table. Please come in, Dr. Ayeda. We're honored by your visit.
Thank you, but it's I who am honored to be your guest.
Would you like some coffee?
No, thank you. It's a blessing to see you, Doctor, but nobody's sick. Ah, of course, I know. Nobody informed you? Obviously not. Anyhow, I've been sent here by Princess Samira. I'm here about... It's about... It's about the gynecological visit. Please pardon me. It's a tradition for every royal family.
It's absolutely out of the question.
Miss Esfandiari, please, I did not want to offend you. I will tell them that...
Tell him the answer is no.
I understand very well.
What do you understand?
Only that a modern woman like yourself would find this to be very offensive.
Dr. Ayadi, I do not hold you personally responsible.
You've been very kind.
Please forgive us, Dr. Ayadi. Please have a nice day. Goodbye. What was I thinking? Soraya!
Can you believe this? How dare they?
Soraya, I know it's not very pleasant, but why don't you think about it? Eva, please talk to her.
I want to go back to Germany as soon as possible.
Soraya. Soraya, please think again. It's only a formality.
Aunt, I care about you. Don't make me say something I'll later regret.
But it's a royal custom. They all do it.
I won't do it. I don't have to prove my virginity to anyone. I'm not a baby-making machine.
I told you so.
Why wasn't I consulted?
Mohammed, my dear, this is the way it's always been done.
Not with her!
Can't we make an exception just this once?
Don't you want a guarantee for your protege? Your reputation, dear Shams, depends on her purity. Don't you think that's the reason she doesn't want to have her checkup?
Samira, stop it.
We cannot make an exception. Just to please that hysterical spider of Mozadik. That conspirator. Who wants you to marry a Bakhtiari. Just to infuriate the English.
Mother!
No stirrups, no wedding.
She's making a terrible mistake.
What's this?
What's happening?
I don't know.
It's them.
They cannot force you to get off. Just relax. Here. Have some nuts.
Let me off.
What are you doing?
Let me out. Soraya, what are you... I'll be right back. Do you want to convince me by force?
Believe me, I knew nothing about it.
Is that all you have to say?
I don't give a damn about the certificate. Soraya, I'm marrying this one very particular Bakhtiari because I love her. And I feel I can't live without you anymore.
All right, I'll eat the nuts.